New World screwworms are not new. They historically were in Texas, and we eradicated them down to the Panama Canal. New World screwworms are a concern because they infest living animals, particularly mammals, and the larvae consume the animal as it's alive, eventually killing it in many cases. The screwworm gets its name because the appearance of the larvae has these hairs that appear as threads on a screw, but also the action of the larvae that appear to drill into that animal's tissue as they're consuming it. They cause damage and then they consume that tissue. We combat the screwworm problem through a number of approaches, including monitoring our animals for infestations of the larvae. We set traps for the adult flies, which allow us to reduce the population of the wild flies. And most importantly, we release sterilized male flies that mate with the wild females. That wild female cannot lay eggs that will hatch. And over time, we reduce that population in an area, ultimately eradicating it. This process continues and repeats as we move that population further and further south, eventually returning it to the quarantine zone in Panama. There are two flies that look very similar. One is the New World screwworm. The second is the secondary screwworm. The secondary screwworm is a species that we have in Texas, and it does not cause this type of damage. The difference involves the stripes on the top of the back of the fly, and it really takes an expert to identify this fly and to tell them apart. But it's very unlikely that anyone will see an adult screwworm fly. You're most likely to identify infestations called meiosis in the animal's wounds. And when you find that, you need to contact a veterinarian immediately.